I have mentioned several times that space is what modifies itself into energy, information, matter, and what we fundamentally call the theater of space-time and causality. So today I want to pose another question, and that is, are mathematical space and mental space the same, and do they project as what we call physical reality? So, first of all, they're not the same, but they could be complementarities. So, mathematical space and mental space could be complementarities. What is mathematical space? It's a formal abstract structure that is used to model and study the physical world. It is defined by a set of axioms that specify the relationship between the points of space. And there are many types of mathematical space, including Euclidean space, topological space, metric space. And what is mental space? Mental space is a cognitive representation of space. It is the way we think about and reason about the spatial world. So, mental space is not a single uniform structure. It is made of a variety of different subspaces, each of which is specialized for a particular task. So, let's take some examples. One example, we have different mental spaces for representing the layout of our home, the route to work, the solar system. So you can see that mathematical space and mental space are related in a number of ways. First, mathematical space can be used to model the relationships between the objects in mental space. For example, the Euclidean distance between two points in mathematical space can be used to model the perceived distance between two objects in space. Second, mental space can be used to visualize and understand mathematical concepts. For example, we can use our mental representation of the number line to help us solve addition and subtraction problems. So, if they are complementary, then they are aspects of our subtle body, and this is the physical body. What you see, this is my physical body, but so is all this. The biosphere, the universe is my physical body. So, in the great traditions of Vedanta, non-duality, there's only one reality, and that one reality is infinite awareness without borders, and it's infinite space, chitakash. And this modifies itself into mental space. And actually, even mathematical space, which then creates or projects as the physical space, which includes the physical body and the entangled physical world as its perceptual activity. So, this is how the causal body, which in my book I refer to as the quantum body, along with Jack Tuzinski, who's a quantum biologist and a quantum physicist, and Brian Fertig, a fellow neuroendocrinologist, we propose that what we call the quantum body is the equivalent of the causal body, the fundamental body of the universe, which is spaceless and timeless. It modifies itself as the mental body. And the mental body is mind, intellect, ego. Now, mind, intellect, and ego are actually qualia experiences, but I hope that mathematical equations in the future can actually point to the structure, the architecture of mental space, which then projects itself as the body of energy, the body of matter, which is entangled with the body of energy and the body of matter that we call the universe. So, who are you? Back to our original chapter 13 in the Upanishads. I am the field, the field of awareness, and I'm the knower of the field of awareness. And what do I know myself as? Mind, intellect, ego, energy, and physical body. In this theater of space, time, and causality, projected simultaneously by mental space and mathematical space as its correlate in mathematics, which is also in the mind. Let me know what you think.